Hello everyone, welcome to all of you in video lectures. So now in this lectures we have to study the roadway construction. So in last video lectures we have seen the road, volume by road, what are the classification of road, what type of equipment are required for the construction of road and what type of materials required for the construction of road. So now in this lectures we have to focus on the roadway construction. Right. So these are the components or parts of the roadway, the carriageway, pavement, curb, shoulder, sidewalks and footpath. Right. So these are the basic components required for any type of the road. So layers of carriageway, the carriageway may be earthwork, maybe a granular subbase, maybe wet mix macadam, maybe bituminous macadam or bituminous concrete. So steps in bitumen road construction. If you want to construct the road, so you have to follow some steps or you have to use some steps, or we can consider the process of bituminous road construction. So in bituminous road construction we require lot of steps. That steps may be preparation of the existing base course layer, application of tack coat, preparation and placing of premix, rolling and quality control of bituminous concrete construction and finish surface. So one by one, preparation of the existing base course layer. The existing surface is prepared by removing the potholes or rust if any. The irregularities are filled in with premix chippings at least 1 week before laying surface course. Right. So this is simple and basic step, that is preparation of the existing base course. So whatever preparations are required for the construction of the road, that you have to follow. So whatever the unobstructed materials, it may be trees, it may be sometimes you have to potholes, it may be some rust area, it may be trees along the path that you have to remove by using some equipment. So whatever irregularities are also you have to fill at least one week before. Right. So this is first step we can consider, that is basic steps we can consider. Six steps you have to consider for this first step. Now second step is, that is application of tack coat. So tack coat layer is also important for the binding purpose of whatever the first layer we have prepared, and on that you have to use some tack coat material, that is bituminous material. Right. So for binding purpose you have to use this application of tack coat. So while application of tack coat, then you have to decide whether that bituminous base or non-bituminous base. So if it is bituminous base, then you have to apply the material for the layer, that is 6.5 to 7.5 kg per 10 meter square area. And if it is non-bituminous material, then 7.5 to 10 kg material kg of material is required for the non-bituminous course. That is depends upon the area. So if it is 10 meter square area, then you have to use the 6.5 to 7 kg material for the bituminous base, and if it is non-bituminous, then 7.5 to 10 kg. Then preparation and placing of premix. So whatever the materials you have prepared or prepared, that you have to mix properly, whether it is a hot mix plant is required, the capacity and desired quality control. Right. So if the material is mixed properly, right, then you have to decide the how much capacity is required, how much quantities required. Right. Side by side you have to check the desired quality control. Right. So if it is hot mix material, means bitumen, you have to melt it properly at a temperature of 150 to 170 degree, 177 degree Celsius is required to heat that material. That bitumen may be a semi-solid form, and you have to check the aggregate temperature also. That aggregate temperature and bituminous temperature should not be differ by 14 degrees Celsius. The hot mix material is collected from the mixture, means once the metal is heated, then you have to collect that material in a collect tank, and you have to transport that material many locations, right? And after the after that, you have to spread that material in a by using mechanical paper machines, and you have to while placing that material, then you have to maintain the camber and thickness of layer, right? So you cannot spread the material randomly, right? So you have to spread the material in a proper way so that we can achieve the camber and we have to achieve the proper thickness, right? So the control of temperature during the mixing and compaction are great significance, right? So you have to maintain the temperature, you have to control the temperature during the mixing also and while spreading the material also, right? So if it is material, means temperature is maintained properly so that we can achieve the compaction properly, so that we can achieve the strain properly, right? So for this, this is the step number 3, that is preparation and placing of premix. Step number 4, that is rolling. So rolling is nothing but it is a compaction, right? Once the bituminous layer, bitumen layer or bituminous concrete is there spread, then you have to compact it, right? So how much speed is required, right? So that is depends upon the thickness and depends upon the material, right? So normally that speed should not be more than 5 km/h, right? So there are some stages: initial stage, intermediate stage and final stage. For initial stage, that rolling is done by 8 to 12 turns roller, and intermediate rolling is done with a fixed wheel pneumatic roller, 15 to 30 tons, having a tire pressure of 7 kg per centimeter square is required. Right. The number of passes. Right. The number of passes required depends on the thickness of layer. Right. How much time we can pass the vehicles on the particular layer. That is depends upon the thickness of layer. And the final rolling or finishing is done by 8 to 10 turn tandem roll. Right. So initial you have to check, intermediate also you have to check, and final you have to check. Right. So that compaction is process is very important for the material, so that we can compact properly and we can achieve the strain properly. Whatever the thickness is required, whatever the layer, whatever the layers are required, and according to that layer, you have to compact the material. Then quality control of bituminous concrete construction. So at every stage, you have to maintain the quality. Right, and you have to check the routine checkup. Routine checkup means whenever the concrete is ready, whenever the bituminous concrete is ready, then you have to check the quality. And what you have to check in the quality, you have to check the aggregate grading, you have to check grade bitumen, you have to check temperature of aggregate, and you have to check the temperature of paving mix during mixing and compaction. So at the time of compaction also you have to check, and during the mixing also you have to check the temperature. Right. So bituminous means hot mix plant. So in the hot mix plant, you have to check the properties of the aggregate, whether that material is means temperature of aggregate you have to check, right? That you have to check routine checkup. That the step number 5, you have to check the routine. So at least one sample for every 100 tons of mix discharged by the hot mix plant is collected and tested over the requirements, right? So at every 100 tons of the mix, right? So whatever the discharging the material from the hot mix plant, that you have to collect and you have to test about the requirements. So you have to check the grading, grade, then yield of bitumen, temperature of bitumen, temperature of paving mix during mixing and compaction. These are the 4 basic periodical checks you have to done at the site. So master test also you have to conduct, that is a flowability test also we can conduct. Then you have to check the density of that material, whether that density we are achieving or not achieving, right? And some variations are allowed for 4.5 meter length of the construction. So 6 mm is allowed variation. So normally 95% density obtained in the laboratory, right? So 100%, generally 100% is required. If it is 95%, then it is okay. But below 95% density is obtained or gate, then we can reject or we can take necessary steps. Then last there is a finished surface. at the finishing stage you have to check whether straight edge, like 3 meter straight edge, you can consider. And during this particular straight edge, you have to check the undulations, you have to check the surface, whether the cracks or any undulations or camber is not properly, slope is not properly, right? Workability is not properly, some reinforcement is showing, that you have to check in the finish the surface. So these are the steps you have to follow for the construction of the road.